Hello students, let's begin with the next poem of your syllabus. To begin with the poem, first I would like to ask you, what do you see in the image given in front of you? You see a lot of insects, right? So today's poem is based on a very interesting and a very funny insect. Let's see what the poet has to say about this insect. So the name of the poem is Try Anti Wanty Gonglop. The name, the title itself is really very funny and very interesting. So let's move ahead. So according to the poet, so according to the description given by the poet, the insect looks something like this. The Try Anti Wanty Gonglop insect looks like this. And he has a very funny wings. He looks like a bee. He is something like a spider. He has fly eyes. He has red back, spider spikes on him. And he is really very funny. Let's see what is the characteristic of this insect, how he behaves, how he lives. There's a very funny insect that you do not often spy, that you do not often see anywhere, that you do not search anywhere because you don't know about it, right? And it is not quite a spider, it is not like a spider, and it is not quite a fly. It is not even like a fly. But it is something like a beetle, and it is little like a bee. Beetle, you know that there is a small insect which is red in color and he has small black spots on him. That is beetle. And honeybee, everyone knows. So he is little like a beetle and something like a bee. But nothing like a woolly grub. Woolly grub means, we have seen those caterpillars, na? How those are before they become a butterfly, how they look. They look like a woolly grub. If you touch them, you feel like itching sensation, right? But nothing like a woolly grub that climbs upon a tree. So he doesn't look like a caterpillar that is climbing upon a tree. Its name is quite hard one, but you'll learn it soon, I hope. So try anti wanty gonglop. So the name of the insect is really very funny. It's try anti wanty gonglop. So students, in the first stanza, you can see that the poet has tried to describe the look, the appearance of the insect, how he looks. He is really funny. The insect is very funny. So you do not search him often. It does not look like a spider. It does not look like a fly. But it is little like a beetle and it is little like a bee. But it also doesn't look like a caterpillar. So he has tried to describe the appearance of the insect in a funny way. It lives on weeds and leaves and has a funny face. Lives on weeds means, what does he eat? What does it eat is, he lives on weeds. Weeds means those plants, those which are grown in the bushes and in the grassland areas. Those weeds and leaves, and has a very funny face. Its appetite is hearty. Appetite means hunger, book. Is hearty means well. How little children have healthy appetite. They like to eat everything. So its hunger, its appetite is hearty. And its manners a disgrace. Manners means he doesn't have good manners. Disgrace means he does not behave properly. When first you come upon it, it will give you a quite scare. Means when the first time you look at it, at the very first meet with the insect, it will give you a quite scare. He will look at you in such a way that you will get little scared. You will be shocked. But when you look for it again, you will find it is not there. And for the second time, when you look again after it, when you start searching for it, for the insect, you will see that he is not there. And unless you call it softly, it will stay away and mop. Means unless you do not call him very softly and with love and affection, it will be mop. Means he will be hiding somewhere. He will be shy. So to call that insect outside, you will have to call his name very sweetly, very lovingly. So try, my dear students, try anti wanty gonglop. It trembles if you tickle it. Trembles means when you tickle someone, when you do tickling sensation to someone, they tremble, means they laugh, they shake so much. Or tread upon its toes. Tread means jumping or moving on its toes. It is not an early riser. It is not an early riser means he does not get up early in the morning. But it has a snobbish nose. Snobbish nose means the one who has running nose, who has cold. If you sneer at it or scold it, it will scuttle in shame. Means sneer at means if you look at angrily, if you look at the insect angrily or scold him, it will scuttle off, it will go off somewhere in shame. But it purrs and purrs quite proudly. Purrs means it is a noise that he is making. What type of noise does the tri-anti-wonti-gonglop make? Purr, purr, like this noise he makes proudly if you call it by its name. And offer it some sandwiches of wax and soap. What is he eating? If you give him some sandwiches of made up of wax and soap. So try. Tri-anti-wonti-gonglop. But of course you have not seen it. And truthfully confess. Means the poet is telling that I know that you have never seen such insect. Because he'd know that such insect doesn't exist. That I haven't seen it either. Even the poet has not seen it yet. And I don't know its address. Means where he lives he doesn't know. For there isn't such any insect. Means he know that there is no such insect in the world. Though there really might have been. Means there would have been, but it is not there. If the trees and grass were purple and the sky was bottle green. Is this possible that the trees and grass is purple in color? No. So the insect, this tri-anti-wonti-gonglop being in real life is also impossible. It's just a joke of mine. The poet is telling the truth now. That it is just a joke. Which you'll forgive, I hope. Now the poet is requesting you to forgive him because it was just a joke. Oh, try. Tri-anti-wonti-gonglop. So now the poet is telling again that try the name once again. Tri-anti-wonti-gonglop. I hope you have understood the poem, students. Go through the poem once again, read it whole, and then complete the activity given in the group. Thank you.